Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find a string is palindrome string or not. So normally what is palindrome string is, if any string after reversing, if I get the same string, that is called palindrome string. So if you read this string from the starting and ending, it will be the same. So this is a palindrome string and welcome, which is a not palindrome string. Now we'll see how we can find whether a string is palindrome or not through Python program. Now let's go to PyCharm. And here I'm creating a new Python file. I will name it as palindrome string. Now let's take a Python file. Now here, what I can do is, first of all, there is one approach I'm going to show you here. So the first approach is, in this approach, first we need to reverse a string. So after reversing the string, if that reverse string is exactly same as original string, that is a palindrome. Now here what I can do is, I'll just take the string input from the user at runtime. So I'll use input method, and here I'll say enter a string. So this string is provided by the user input, okay, and then I can store that into variable. I'll just create a variable called s now, which contains a string. So first of all, we need to reverse the string. So to reverse the string, we don't have a straightforward method or function. So we have to use a slicing operator. So let's see how we can use a slicing operator first, and then I'll show you how to reverse the string by using slicing operator. So let's say, when I say print, yes, in the bracket, I'll say a single colon, right? So what does that mean is, here starting and ending point, we have to specify, let's say here 1 or 5, something like this. So if I don't specify anything, it will get the string from the beginning and end, then it will print everything. Now when I run this code, let us say enter a string, let's say A, B, C, D, E, and 5 characters I have given. So when I give 5 characters, it's printed exactly the same way. So the colon is an operator which will print. So if I don't specify starting point, ending point, it will give you everything. And we can also write the same thing like this. Suppose the starting point, let's say, let me just say I'm providing A, B, C, D, E, F as an input. All right. So here, 0 is a position, 0 is a 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 0 to 5. I can just specify here 0 to 5. So 0 to 5 NSA, and it will give you exactly how many characters. So let's say A, B, C, D, E. So now it will give you exactly the same. So this is also exactly the same. So if I specify the locations, starting and ending point, it will give you the string. Or if I don't specify anything, it will conserve from the starting point to ending point. And suppose, so same expression, if I write like this, colon, I'll say 1. So what is 1 means? It's incremental. So 0 to 5, it will go and give you one more step. So when I run this, it will also give you everything. Let me just say A, B, C, D, DE. So it will also give you the same thing. So this is basically means one step ahead. So from 0 to next step value, second first step, next step, next step, it will go to 5 steps. And suppose I want to give same thing like this. Let's say I haven't not specified any starting value, ending pointing, and also step value or not, also I'm not specifying. Now what this will give you is, this will basically give you the same thing. So again, the same thing. So how it is printed is the same thing means, if I'm not specifying any starting point, it will consider as a 0. If I don't specify any ending point, it will consider at the end of the string, that is 5. And even if you don't specify any step, it will by default consider as a 1. So it is giving the same thing. But now I want to get the string in reverse order from the last to beginning. So same expression, I will write like step value, I'll say -1. So when I say -1 step value, it will give the string from the end to beginning. Now when I run this code, it will give you, let me just say A, B, C, D, E. So it will give you in reverse order. So this is a -1. So this is in reverse order, right? So now this expression is gives a reverse order, a reverse string. So after getting this reverse string, I can store that in some variable. Let me comment on these things. This is we need, so because we need to reverse a string. After getting the string, we have to reverse a string, and I don't want to print the reverse string. I want to store that reverse string in some other variable, Let's say rev str. And after that, this reverse string is equal to exact our original string, that is a palindrome number. So here I'll write one if condition. If reverse str equal to s, that is our original string, then here I'll say print palindrome, or else so we can say print not palindrome. Okay, so that's all. So first we need to capture the string and reverse it, and then compare both the strings are same. If the both the strings are same, it is a reverse, so palindrome, and it is not palindrome if it's not equal. Now let us run this code. Now here I'm just printing madam, so this is a palindrome string. Let's say palindrome. Now again one more time run this. Now this time I'll say welcome, so this is not palindrome string. Okay, so this is how we can find a string is a palindrome string or not. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.